Hello friends, myself S.M.Math, assistant professor from Mechanical Engineering Department of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am explaining regarding the calculating the length of the open belt drive. In the previously I am explaining regarding the calculating the length of the cross belt drive. The learning outcomes for this session is student will able to calculate the length of the open belt drive. Now, in the previous one, I am explaining regarding the derivation of the cross belt drive. I hope you were going through this last video, and understand it. Now, here is a question for that one. If motion transmission from clockwise to anticlockwise direction, which belt drive is used? I hope you have to think over that. I am explaining in the last video regarding this one. Yes, for answer for this one is for transmission of motion from clockwise to anticlockwise direction, you can use the cross belt drive. Okay. Now, today I am explaining regarding the transmission of motion from the clockwise to the clockwise direction, that is for the open belt drive. So here I am showing the diagram. This is a driver having radius R1 and it is a R2. So here O1 is the center of the driver shaft or driver pulley, and O2 is the center of the driven shafts, and the distance between these two is a C. Now the belt is come in contact with starting from at a point A to B, that is belt is not in contact with the pulley, then again come in contact with from B F and then it comes to C to D and from C E A. So that is the total length of the belt. You have to calculate how much the bend length of the belt you have to require. Now R1 is a radius for this larger pulley, this R1, and R2 is a radius for the smaller pulley. C is the distance between the two shafts. Now for the length of total length, you have to go for length L is equal to this arc C E A. It's arc CEA. Arc CEA plus this length AB plus arc BFD. So CEA, AB, BFD, and the last one is DC. Length DC. Okay. Now, you have to assume that this length AB and CD are equal one. So, AB is equal to CD. Okay. AB is equal to CD. Now, length, total length is equal to this arc CEA is double of that. That is arc EA. That is arc AE and arc EC is the same one. So you have to take here 2 times arc EA plus this AB. AB and CD are equal one. I am taking here as AB, 2 times of AB plus arc again BFD. So FB is and FD are equal one. So I am taking 2 times of arc BF. Okay. Okay. Now this arc EA means it is a pi by 2 plus alpha. What is alpha? So from O2 draw one line parallel to AB. So it is a point G, it intersected. So O2G is perpendicular to O1A, and again, and this angle, that is GO21, angle GO21 is equal to alpha, is equal to angle, the same angle, that is angle AO1A dash is equal to angle again BO2B dash. So this is angle alpha. ठीक है. सो नाउ दिस लेंथ ए बी, बिकॉज हियर यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द लेंथ ए बी. दिस लेंथ ए बी इज इक्वल टू ए बी एंड ओ टू जी आर इक्वल वन. ठीक है. सो कॉस अल्फा इज इक्वल टू ओ टू जी बाय ओ वन ओ टू. देयरफॉर कॉस अल्फा इज इक्वल टू कॉस अल्फा इज इक्वल टू ओ टू जी बाय ओ वन ओ टू. ओ टू जी बाय ओ वन ओ टू. ओ टू जी मीन्स ए बी इज इक्वल टू ए बी बाय ओ वन ओ टू. ओ वन ओ टू मीन्स दिस डिस्टेंस इज सी वन सी. देयरफॉर ए बी इज इक्वल टू सी कॉस अल्फा. ठीक है. दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ ए बी. नाउ पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ एंड अगेन वन मोर थिंग इज हियर साइन अल्फा. Because we have to calculate the value of alpha, then you have to go for the length. What is the sine alpha? Sine alpha is equal to sine alpha is equal to O1G divided by O1O2. O1G divided by O1O2. What is the O1G? O1G, this total length is R2. O1G means AO1 minus GO1. A O 1, this A O 1, total radius minus G O 1, divided by O 1 O 2, O 1 O 2 means C 1. So what is the A O 1? A O 1 means R 1 minus G O 1 means it is equal to R 2, same length is to be there. So R 1 minus this length is R 2, R 1 minus R 2 by C, that is the sine alpha. Therefore sin alpha is equal to R1 minus R2 by C. ठीक है. सो इट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ ए बी. इट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन अल्फा. नाउ एज यू टू चेक दैट दिस व्हाट यू कॉल दिस वैल्यू ओ वन ए ओ वन माइनस जी ओ वन इज अ वेरी स्मॉल. ए ओ वन एंड जी O1, this subtraction is very small, and when the distance between the center of the two shafts or the two pulley is larger one and C is larger, this value is C, then sine alpha is nearer to alpha as it is a very small. ठीक है. साइन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू नाउ यू नो द वैल्यू ऑफ ए बी. यू नो द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन अल्फा. यू नो द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन अल्फा एज वेरी क्लोज टू दिस वन. यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस अल्फा. दैट इज कॉस स्क्वायर अल्फा प्लस साइन स्क्वायर अल्फा इज इक्वल टू वन. देयरफॉर कॉस स्क्वायर अल्फा इज इक्वल टू सॉरी कॉस अल्फा इज इक्वल टू वन माइनस साइन स्क्वायर अल्फा. और cos alpha is equal to 1 minus sin square alpha raised 1 by 2, or cos alpha is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 sin square alpha plus by binomial expansion. It is a binomial expansion, this value. Cos alpha is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 sin square alpha. But alpha, sin alpha is equal to alpha. Therefore, cos alpha is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 alpha square. This is the value. So it is the value first. This is sin alpha 2, 3, and this value is a 4, 1. So we have to calculate all these values. AB, that is length, sin alpha, value of sin alpha, R1 minus R2 by C, and value of cos alpha. Now, you have to take on the first equation, this one. What is the length? So, length L is equal to R, 2 times R AE, put the value, 2 times. What is the arc EA? Arc EA means pi by 2 plus alpha. pi by 2 plus alpha into r1. This is the value of r ea. What is the value of ab? Ab is value of c cos alpha. C into cos alpha. And then value of arc BF. Value of arc BF means is pi by 2 minus alpha. Here we have to take a pi by 2 plus alpha for a larger pulley, and for smaller pulley this length is pi by 2 minus alpha. Pi by 2 minus alpha into r2. Okay. Now length L is equal to 2 times into bracket pi by 2 into r1 plus alpha r1 plus c cos alpha plus pi by 2 into r2 minus alpha into r2. Now multiply 2 in the bracket, multiply in the 2 bracket. So length L is equal to pi r1 plus 2 alpha r1 plus 2c cos alpha plus pi r2 minus 2 alpha r2. Now taking the group together, pi into bracket r1 plus r2, these two value, plus 2 alpha into bracket r1 minus r2 plus 2c cos alpha. What is the value of cos alpha? Value of 1 minus 1 by 2. 1 minus 1 by 2 alpha square. So length L is equal to pi into bracket r1 plus r2 plus 2 alpha r1 minus r2 plus 2c into 1 minus 1 by 2 alpha. What is the value of alpha? R1 minus r2. As sin alpha is equal to r1 minus r2, alpha is equal to, because sin alpha is equal to alpha, r1 minus r2 by c. You have to write r1 minus r2 by c bracket square. So length L is equal to pi into bracket r1 plus r2 plus, again here alpha is r1 minus r2 by c into r1 minus r2 plus 2c into bracket, sorry, 2c minus 2c minus 2 to get cancelled, c is get cancelled, r1 minus r2 bracket square by c. So length L is equal to pi into bracket r1 plus r2 plus 2 into bracket r1 minus r2 bracket square upon c plus 2c minus r1 minus r2 bracket square upon c. This get cancelled here. So length L is equal to pi into bracket r1 plus r2 plus 2 r1 minus r2 square by c, r1 minus r2 by 1 get cancelled here. So it is r1 minus r2 bracket square upon c plus 2c. So total exact length of the open belt drive L is equal to pi into bracket r1 plus r2 plus 2c plus r1 minus r2 bracket square by c. So it is a formula for calculating the exact length of the open belt drive for AB, BFD from DC and CEA. What is the formula? Length L is equal to pi into bracket r1 plus r2 plus 2c plus r1 minus r2 bracket square by c, where c is equal to distance between the two shafts or two pulley. R1 is a radius, this r1 is a radius for the larger pulley, r2 is a radius for the smaller pulley. So from this formula you can calculate the exact length of the open belt drive. So for these references I am using for this video BK single book.